initial state into transition matrix, it will be final state which is the same as the initial state. At that case, matrix it will be initial state into transition matrix equal initial state. This is steady state. By solving for above equation, we can find the steady state matrix the solution will be same as 25% and 75%. So, but after how many runs it will go to the steady state, it depends on the problem. But it is limit finite. Means it is not in very large numbers. It can go steady state in 6, 10, 20 runs. Now we will go to the example number 2, crazy bank. Crazy bank deals with both assets and liability products in retail bank industry. A big portfolio of the bank is based on loans. Means this bank, crazy bank, is the most fund which is giving is for loans. Means they are giving loans to people. People, they will do some project. After some time, they will return the money with some interest. This is crazy bank what is doing. So this loans makes the majority of the total revenue earned by the bank. Now they want some advisor is to continue by this loans or to stop. Based on the information which will come later. Hence, it is very essential for the bank to find the proportion of the loans which have a high propensity to be paid in full, and those which will finally become bad loans. Because loans always not paid on. Some people, they will take loan and they will not pay. They will not return back. So, in this case, some money we can say it is died money. Expired money, because it is totally non-paid. So crazy bank has hired you, is telling you means as operation research specialist, as a consultant, to come up with these scoping numbers. There is numbers here. As we told always in this problem, we have to understand 100% what is the logic of the problem. If we understand it, if we understood it, then we will solve it. So all the loans which have been issued by Crazy Bank can be classified into four categories. There is good loans. These are the loans which are in progress. Now we paid for Ahmed some money and Ahmed will pay after some time. But we know that Ahmed is good and he will pay back. This means good loans. These are loans which are in progress but are given to low risk customers. Those good customers. We expect most of these loans will be paid up in following time. So this is good loans. Some loans which are risky loans. These are also the loans which are in progress. Now we pay, but for crazy people, they are not paying. Almost. So we are telling this type of loans is risky. But are given to medium or high risk customers. We expect a good number of these customers will default. So he is expecting that most of these people, they will not pay. So the money will be default. And we have another two types. See, bad loans and paid-up loans. Bad loans and paid-up loans, they are not in progress. They already finished. Bad loans, the customer to whom these loans were given have already defaulted. There is some loans we paid for a long time, before 2, 3, 4, 5 years, and not paid, and cannot be paid. So this money is it is not in the hand of the bank. So these two, it will give us to the one fundamental parameter in Markov chain, which is the important things, is the absorbing nodes. Means absorbing nodes, The option is coming of two bad loans cannot take others, cannot go more debts. If it is decided to be bad loans or unpaid loans, so it cannot be paid again. Paid up loans, these loans have already been paid in full. So the first two are in progress. The first, second, two, and third and fourth are not in progress. Either paid totally or not paid. So cannot be paid or paid totally. So what is absorbing loans? Absorb in English means, or even in chemistry, absorb means when the surface is absorbed some things, it will catch it. So these absorbing loans, if any value come to inside, it will not go out. That's what the meaning of the absorbing loans. Like in these two, we can say absorbing loans. Bad loans, it is not, it is unpaid money, so it is unpaid. We cannot pay again. So whatever money comes to this category, bad loans, it is absorbed to inside. So we cannot take from bad loans to risky loans. But there above, because they are in progress, we can change from good loans to risky loans. And also in the last example, we can change market share from Pepsi to Coke. So they are not absorbing. Absorbing means once enter this node, it will not leave. Absorbing loans is a Markov chain. In a Markov chain are the possible end states, end stop. All nodes in Markov chains have an array of transition probability to all other nodes. And then leave. But absorbing nodes have no transition probability to any other node. Hence, if any individual lands up to this state, he will stick to this node forever. So anything will come to this one, it will stick, it will be absorbed. Let's take a simple example. Here it is good. We are making a Markov chain for a bell, which is being passed in Parliament's house. You know this bell, in Parliament's house, if Parliament's people are not accepted, it will be diamonds. That means it will be absorbed. It has a sequence of steps to follow, different steps. The end states are always either it becomes a law or it is scrapped. So your bill, it is in progress in Parliament. Parliament is giving some laws. If Parliament accepted, so it will be okay. If it is not accepted, so this thing is called absorbing rules. Because if it is not accepted, so it is dead, this bill. These two are said to be absorbing loans. For the loans example, bad loans and paid up loans, that's the third and fourth, are in states and hence absorbing loans. So let's solve this problem. We have good loans and we have risky loans. See, paid loans, paid up, there is no share, it is share itself only. 100% go from paid up to paid up. Similar things, bad loans, which is finished, which will not pay, so it is 100% from itself only. However, good loans is giving that, this matrix is giving you information from the market that good loans, 70%, it will stay in good loans. Those people who are in the category of good loans, 70%, they will pay good loans. 5%, it will change to risky loans. 3%, it will change to bad loans. And 22%, it will change to bad loans. So, this is total of what is coming out from the good loans, it should be 100%. So 70% it will stay as good loans. We can predict it. 5% it will change to risky. 2-3% it will not pay, and 22% it will pay. Same thing, risky loans, 55% it will stay itself. And 5% it will be paid, and the large number that is 35% is also, it will not be paid bad goods. And 5% it will go good goods. So these good loans and risky loans are captured to others. But bad loans and bad loans, that's by themselves only. They can take from others but will not give to others. They will catch 5% from risky loans and catch these bad loans, 22% of good loans. However, bad loans, that it will not be paid, 30% of good loans and 35% of risky loans. This information we can tabulate it in matrix, that it will be the transition. Explaining absorbing loans becomes simple. Becomes simple for this diagram. As you can see, paid up. And bad loans transitions, this is paid up, and this bad loans only transition only to themselves. So bad loans is 100% to itself. And bad loans is distributed only. But it can absorb more from others. Hence, whatever bad approaches take, if it lands up to one of these two states, it will stay there forever. So we expect that bad loans, it will increase. Because we have 35 here, there is feet. It is taking from risky loan 35% and 33% from here. And also bad up will increase because 5% is coming from here and 22% will come from here. So these two will increase, and this too it will decrease up to some long. So after some long time, then maybe this one becomes zero, and this one is become number, this one is become number. If this one is greater than, so we can say the loans for bank it is okay. If the risk is more and many loans are not paid, for example, 45 or 50%, so we can advise the bank to stop this process. A bad loan cannot become paid up, or risky or good loans ever after. Same is true with paid up. So now, the concept of absorbing, I think it is clear from this example. Transition calculations. Whatever written there, it is there. For good, 70% will stay good, 5% it will transfer to good, to risky, 3% it will be to bad loans, and 22% it will be bad up. For risky, 5% it will change to good, 55% will stay in the risky loans, and 35% that is bad number, it will change to bad, and also 5% it will be. And for bad, it will go only to bad. Because it is absorbing loans, the remaining are zeros. So this one, bad to bad, it is 100%. Bad up to bad up is 100%, the remaining is zeros. Because it is absorbing loans. This is initial state and this is final state. So he is telling that in the information currently, once we have 1 year transition probability, we'll study for after each 1 year, 1 year, this information. We can convert prediction algorithm to simple matrix multiplication. Currently, the portfolio has 60% good and 40% risky loans. And based on that, zero bad and zero beta. We don't know, so we'll make it zero. We look forward to calculate how many of these loans will be finally paid up in 4 years. Using 1 year transition probability, we can estimate the number of loans falling into each of the 4 pockets after 1 year time. So we'll make one matrix because it is 4. We'll make here 4. 60% good, 40% risk, 0% bad, and 0. After 1 year, if we multiply these things, we multiply this line into this one. We will get one number. It will come 44 weeks. And we multiply this one into this one, it will become 25. And bad is 60% and paid out 50%. So after 1 year, 16% of the loan will not be paid as the decision, and 15 only will be paid. The remaining will be good and risky. If we continue this calculation for 2, 3, 4 years, then what we'll see? Let's discuss what it is. Here are some interesting insights from this calculation. We can expect 15% of the loans to be paid up in this year, and 16 being ending up as bad loans. As the percentage of bad loans seems to be on a higher side. Bad loans now become 16%. That's why. It will be beneficial to identify these loans and make adequate intervention. Pinpointing of this 15% is not possible using simple Markov chains, but same is possible using latent Markov chains. Now we will continue for the second year. If we want to take the second year, we will take the output from the first year and make it as input, starting. So 45, 44%, 25%, 16%, 15%. We will multiply with the same transition matrix. Transition matrix is a static matrix predicted from market and assumed not to be cheap. So if we multiply it after 2 years, 32% of loans, it will be good, 60% risk, 26% bad, 26% is beta. Now, we see that beta has become same as bad loans. Now, to make a prediction of 2 years, we can use the same transition matrix. This time, the initial proportion will be the final proportion of the last calculations. As we know, these things we will take from the last calculation, what we got. Transition probability generally don't change much. This is because it is based on several time points in past. Transition probability generally don't change much. This is because it is based on several time points in the past, as we do. If we keep on repeating this exercise, we calculated for the 3rd year, 4th year, 5 years, 6 years. We see the proportion matrix convex. Following is the convergent matrix. Note that multiplying it with transition matrix makes no change to proportions. So if we make calculation for 3rd year, 4th year, 5 years, 6 years, 7 years, in matrix, it will become like this. Good, it will become zero because it will be bad or not bad. Also, it will be bad or not bad. So, after many calculations, out of all total money, 46% will not be bad totally. And 54% it will be bad up. And if you multiply these things by matrix, it will give you the same calculations. So, means these things, it will not change totally, always. It will come to the steady state when the initial state, it will finally change. This is called the steady state. So, based on that, we can advise the bank what to do, to continue with loans or not. The bank is giving about 6% interest, 6% only. But now result is telling 64% of people will not pay back the money. So the bank is in bad situation. Bank should stop this scenario of these loans or change the rules or do some other things. These are the proportion numbers we are looking for. 54% of the current loans will be paid up in full, but 46 will be defaulted. Hence, doing this simple exercise leads us to such an important conclusion that the current portfolio exposes bank to a very high risk. Because very high money will not be paid. So, it gives us information about the future. To decide to continue or stop. So now they are telling that 46 66% of the money which we loan to other, it will not be paid out. So this means the bank